Welcome to a Manager Plus webinar. My name is Kevin Sloan. I'm a certified electronic health record specialist and certified ophthalmic technician. Management Plus is an industry leader in EHR, and we want to provide you with the documentation tools and the skills to use these tools proficiently. Today's webinar is titled Patient Demographics for EHR. Let's get started. You can see on my test database here, I have a patient, a historical figure pulled up. His name is George Patton. He's a patient that we do quite a bit of testing on. We are focusing on the EHR tab sheet down in demographics. You can see that we have all of these other tab sheets here, but we're going to look just at the EHR tab sheet and take a look at what you can glean from this section of Management Plus. Starting at the far left, you'll see an icon. It's a green circle with a check mark. This column indicates whether or not the record has been finalized. So you can see here's a record that's been finalized, here's another, and right on down the list. Every record that's been finalized has that green circle with a white check mark in it. The second column is a padlock that indicates whether or not the record is locked, and there are no locked records at this point. We'll talk more about the lock record and the log manager in a separate webinar. The third column has a blue circle. It's actually a globe, if that was really zoomed in on, with a check mark and then a green arrow. It's very small, hard to see, but it's really what it is. And that basically indicates that this record has been published to the portal. So you can see this particular record has been published to the portal, and none of the other records have been. The next column is the date of service. So you can see that essentially every record has the same creation date as the date of service. They do not necessarily have to be. In fact, in your office, they probably will not be. I don't think I have any, or I'm not noticing any that are different. When I usually do a test, I'll create it and then save it the same day. But if you're prepping your records in advance for patients that are coming in tomorrow or the next day, you'll have a creation date of today with the date of service of whenever they're coming in. That's perfectly fine to do that. So that's date of service. Here's creation date. The next one is the visit type. Depending on your type of office, whether or not you do ophthalmology or optometry or a little of both, the name of your visit type could be different. It may say exam ophthalmology, it may say optometry, and so forth. So this is the name of the template arrangement. You'll probably have one that says correspondence as well. You may have one that says tech only. I don't think there's a tech only one here, but it could be, you know, several different names depending on what types of forms that you have. The visit description column is essentially a brief note that you have given in regards to this type of exam. It's sort of a very brief snapshot of what is going on here. So during some testing, I put all types of notes on here. You will probably have things like IOP check or glasses exam or CE for comprehensive exam or a 1 year exam or yearly check. However you do that, that's fine. You'll see those descriptions there. So don't worry about if the visit type doesn't say post-op or 1 day post-op. You'll put that in your description. If it's a CAT check or glasses recheck, it'll go in the visit description. Every one of these actually has a visit description. But you do not necessarily have to. It's not mandatory. The system will recommend that you put a description in there, but it's not mandatory. But it's always a good idea. The next column is the status. Think of this as a sticky note. It's something that needs to be done. You can see here on this particular record, there's a status of pending surgery, the same way with that one. And there's no other statuses on any of the other records. That means that you have something that needs to be done to this record. Essentially, a completed record has a blank status. We'll talk more about the sign-off work list and how to filter out statuses and how it can be used to your advantage in another webinar. Moving to the right are the four master diagnoses, and you can see that my system is set up to bring forward those diagnoses, so they're almost the same for everyone. That one's a little bit different, but otherwise they're the same. So you can see the four master diagnoses. Your system could have seven. I've seen some of them have up to 12, but depending on your system, you will have various numbers of diagnoses on your form, but you'll always see four displayed here. The next column is the physician name. So Dr. Tehash is the physician that has seen this patient every time. You may have multiple physicians, so it's good to be able to see that physician name right there. My system is set up to bring forward the last physician from the last record automatically. Creation staff column. I'm always signing them as system administrator, but in your office, this is going to actually have the name of your staff member that created the record, the one that actually initially created that. So they'll have various numbers of names here. The record locked by column, we've already seen on this side whether or not a record has been locked. This column here tells you who has it locked. So if somebody's in the record, and you try to reopen it yourself, it will tell you so-and-so has this record open. Do you want to open it in read-only mode? You'll probably want to just click no and then just view the narrative. But if you were just looking down through these columns and wanted to see who had locked the record, their name would be displayed. The next two columns give you details about the records, whether or not or when they were finalized, and who finalized that person or that record. So you can see that this record is finalized here, and you can always see that over on the far right hand side or left hand side actually by the green icon. This gives you the name. I'm always signed in as system administrator, so you'll see that name on all of these. This should be your physician. It should not be anybody else in your office. This is the electronic signature. No different than signing a paper chart with a pen, so it has to be your physician. And then the next column is when they did that. We'll give you more details about how to finalize in the most efficient manner in another webinar. So that is all the columns. These columns can be moved, so you can drag and drop this if you want this over here, and so forth, and you can move it back. They can be sorted. By clicking this, a good one to sort is like the date of service. You click it once, it puts the oldest one on the top and the newest on the bottom. That's how it is by default. I like to have it to where the most recent one is on the top, so I don't have to scroll down to get to that every time. So just by clicking that one more time, it will sort that. You can do that for every one of these. So just clicking the top here, it will change that around for you. Generally, I like to have the most recent record on the top sorted by the date of service. Every one of these columns has that feature built into it. You can also sort any of these columns that you want. When you hold your mouse pointer over the column and the header section, you can see this filter appear. When you move it down, it goes away. So as it comes up, it appears, down, it goes away. You can filter out any of these or apply multiples. Let's just choose diagnosis one. If I wanted to see all the records where the diagnosis one was incipient cataract, I would click that. And you can see that it strips everything out except for that specific diagnosis that I have filtered this column by. It's easy to find specific records if you're looking for information. So, say your description was 1 year cat check and you wanted to find all of those records that had that. You could use that filter. You can go back into the filter, uncheck it to remove it, or in the lower left corner, you can see this. You can click the red X and it will remove that filter there. All of these have that. So your visit description, it's a good idea when you do that to put your descriptions in uppercase and use a standardized method of doing that, maybe 10 or 15 at the most, so that it is worthwhile. But if you say the same thing but a different case or different verbiage, it will be unique. So let's just say good test after revisions. I've got a bunch of those that are exactly the same. Or let's just say new revision. I've just got one. Here's one that more normal, what you'll have, routine glaucoma exam. So there's only one. You could leave that filter in and then apply a second filter as well. So let's just choose incipient cataract. You can see that with this filter and that one, there are no records that meet that criteria. So just be aware of that. And also, if you look on this, be aware that there are some filters in here. You may think that there are no records for this patient. You'll just clear that out to access that. Okay. Every one of these records could potentially have attachments, and they could have drawings and so forth. So how would you access that information? You will right-click that record, and I don't have to left-click it first. I can just right-click over that. I could left-click it and then right-click it. It's kind of an extra click, but essentially I can just right-click over that. I'll get this menu option here. New will allow me to create a new record. Open existing, well, I really don't train folks to do that because it's better to just double-click on it, which is faster than right-click and then moving your mouse up to open existing. But that would open that current record, that record that's selected. Show deleted visits is going to show you all the records that have been deleted. So let's just do that. And you can see there are no records there at all. This could lead to some confusion if you left it like this. And then you walk back, you think you might not have any records for this patient. You know, they all disappeared. Well, in a matter of speaking, they kind of did. Just right-click on this and just make sure that this is unchecked and all your records will come back. If you right-click, the next option, again, is View Narrative. This is the fastest way possible to review the data that's been documented in the record. So there's only three times you really ever need to open a record. One is if you're going to add new data and save it. Two is if you're going to post charges. And three is if you're going to export a CCD document out. So to review the data that's been documented, to access any Word documents, any drawings, or attachments, you can do it all right from here by right-clicking. So let's review the narrative for this particular record. You can see that it does display all of the information that was documented on this particular record on 714. Okay, this is considered the narrative. There is another narrative that we will refer to as the runtime narrative. That's when you have the record open and your narrative on. You're running the record and it's open. We are not running the record right now. It is not open. It is not in the data entry mode. This is data review. So I can type all day long and data will not appear on this because this is just data review. And this is just the standard narrative. It is not the runtime narrative. It's okay to click the red X here. We'll talk more about the runtime narrative in another webinar. You can access more than one narrative at a time. So if I want this one and this one, I can hold my control key down and select that. Or if I wanted this one and all three of these, you can hold shift and select all three. You can get as many of those as you want. Just for this, we'll just select these two, right click, view narrative, and it will tile both of those narratives immediately in front of you. It's nice that you can slide those off to the side. Not much on this, just a logo here. But here's what you're going to normally see is this normal patient data. Okay. Clicking Alt F4 will close these windows, or clicking the red X in the corner, or double clicking the management icon in the left corner, or clicking once on that icon and choosing close will close those out. Either option is perfectly fine. Let's leave those selected. Right click again, print narrative. This will allow you to print to paper if you choose. So you'll want to click printer. Here's my default printer. By doing OK, it will print that out. I had two records selected and highlighted. So it will actually print those one right after another. If you wanted to print to a PDF, an electronic version of the narrative, you would click File, in the drop-down list, choose PDF. This is a floppy disk. You'll choose that. You'll pick your location. It can be on your network. It can be on your desktop, anywhere on your computer at all. And you'll give it a name. Let's say this is George Patton narrative 7114, and that's 714. Let's put the year on there, and 6/19/15. Okay, so I'll do that and then do OK, and it will give me a message indicating that that has been exported out. Actually, it did not, but it has been exported out. It'll be sitting on my desktop, and right there it is. That's where I chose to put it. Okay. Right-click again on these two selected records, and I can view the attachments. These attachments might be your test results for an OCT, visual field, or whatever you have attached. It could be a word merge, a letter to a referring physician. We'll go more into the attachment section later and how you can manage this and the various methods to get files into the attachment section. It's very easy to do. So those two records don't have any attachments. You always can right-click and do select all if you know there's an attachment there, but you're not sure what record has it. Just select them all, right-click, and then view attachments, and now you'll see all of the attachments for all of those records. Okay. We'll talk more about how to manage this and how to filter items out from this, and we'll talk more about that in another webinar. Okay, let's go back to just having the top two selected. Right-click again, view thumbnails. Think of thumbnails as image files. So that would be like a bitmap file, PNG, a TIFF, or a JPEG file. And it's going to generate a little window here in just a second, hopefully. While it's thinking about that, it's worth noting that at the top when it says not responding, it doesn't really mean it's hung up or frozen. It's just Windows method of telling you to hold on for a minute, to give it some time, that it's thinking. It just says, hey, give me a second here. I'm thinking about this. Some things may take more or less time than others. Generally, that comes up quite fast. So let's see what... see how long it takes to generate that window. Yeah, it could be, since I'm recording this, that it's using my CPU's memory up and it's slowing it down. But that would generally be almost instant and come up very, very quick. But it is not, so I'm hoping that it will come up here. But it is thinking. It is still thinking about it. So you may see some image files within your attachments, and that is perfectly normal. But when you come into the thumbnails section of Management Plus, you're only going to see just true image files. So if that ever comes up, I'll be able to show you. Still thinking about it. If you click on this, you'll notice the screen turned kind of whitish. That's just another Windows technique of telling you that it's thinking. Just to hang on for a little bit. And I may decide not to hang on for a little bit, and I may just shut the system down here. Via the task manager, since it seems to be taking much too long. And I'm sure the recording process has a lot to do with this. There we go. All right, let's get this thing back up here again. All right, so we've got him up here. Let's see if we can get this thing to do what we want. Let's right click and view thumbnails. It doesn't like to view the thumbnails while we're in the recording process. That's not so good. Let's try just one record at a time. Doesn't like that either. All right, let's skip that for the moment. All right, so we're going to right click on this. You'll see it says view all lab results. If you have an interface that is set up with your favorite lab, an HL7 interface, you'd be able to view those results right from here. Import and export visit, I really won't talk about those a lot. That's in those rare cases where you're traveling to a satellite office and you don't have RDP connectivity and you have a database on your laptop and you want to export those records out, import them in your live database and so forth. Very seldom used. A select all, as I mentioned, it will select all the records. And then the last option is a refresh. So if you had a locked record or had finalized a record and this was open and you wanted to see those icons appear, you could refresh this and it would refresh that information on there. The last thing we'll mention on this is how to create a new record. Right click. Click New or press the letter N on your keyboard. And again, you will see various template descriptions up here. It'll be either ophthalmology or optometry. You'll probably have a correspondence, a tech only. If you have an ASC, you will see that. And basically, you can just double click on this and it will open, or you can click once and do open. Or since this is at the very top, you can hit the Enter key and it will open it as well, and that will create a brand new record. We'll go into that record in another webinar. Thank you very much for your attention. Have a great day.